On August 14th, President Lowe gave the go-ahead for an independent investigation to determine whether the Maryland football program had an alleged toxic culture.
The report was officially released on Thursday, but the lengthy 200-page document was presented to the University System of Maryland Board of Regents on Tuesday.
They come up with these recommendations and statements that aren't that shocking if you've been following the story.
University President Wallace Lowe ordered the investigation. It followed an ESPN expose about the football team after the death of redshirt freshman Jordan McNair.
The university assesses legal and moral responsibility for the mistakes that our training staff made on that fateful workout day.
The commission interviewed more than 150 people, but also reached out to every student who played for the Terps since Coach DJ Durkin was hired. The findings: the commission unanimously decided that the athletics department lacked a culture of accountability and did not provide adequate oversight of the football program.
I think the coach had all the tools necessary to do his job.
It also spoke about former strength and conditioning coach Rick Court deciding that he acted inappropriately and that Coach Durkin and the athletics department share responsibility of his oversight.
It shouldn't have taken 2 months to decide that.
Despite that, the commission concluded that there is not a toxic culture surrounding the team.
Treat the kids as human beings. I mean, that's where they made the mistake.
So what's next? It's up to the Board of Regents.
Will DJ Durkin return to coach the football team? Is the athletic director in a position to continue his job? And, and where does the university president, Wallace Lowe, stand on all this?
The Board of Regents now has control over the investigation, and there's no timeline for when the board may make any decisions. In College Park, Danielle Stein, CNS-TV.